Ladies and gentlemen, guys and gals, we are back this week with Voice of the Giants here at WKCV 103.5 LPFM, the voice of Keystone College. Cross Country is with us this week. Glad to have them aboard. We have here Coach Hankins and Cameron with us, coach and runner. Gentlemen, glad to have you aboard joining us this week. Usually you'll be with JT, but obviously JT's not here with us due to unforeseen circumstances. But nonetheless, glad to have you here and glad to get episode 35 out there and rolling. So, gentlemen, welcome to the studio.
Hello.
Thank you.
Awesome, awesome. So, Cam, I'm going to start with you. Obviously, you're a senior this year. You're a top runner coming from Maryland, obviously. You had a fifth place overall, place of 13 when you guys faced a Gloucester College, and then you were one of six for your CSEC preview, and you came in first for that running. So tell us a little bit about yourself and how you go about approaching yourself for a meet.
So hello, everybody. I'm Cameron Bryce here. I'm a senior. My major is hospitality, and I minor in event planning and business. So typically, leading up to any race, I'm always nervous, no matter what. Going into any race, I try to, you know, as much as I can, just try to breathe. You know, it's just the nerves really get the best of me. But like, as soon as I start running, it just all goes away. And you know, I've been running for so long, so those nerves are never just gonna go away. Each race literally feels like my first race ever. That's how nerve-wracking it is. So I try to take each race, you know, just breathe in and out, and you know, try to just overcome everything I can.
Awesome, and obviously having nerves and breathing practices and all that, that's normal for an athlete, which is why you need to have great coaches behind you. Yes. So, Coach, you started here back in the spring of 2020. You're relatively new to the program here at Keystone. You've built it up so quick, and you have such an impressive senior core here with your group. First of all, welcome to Keystone. I've always ever said that
to
you.
Thank you.
But, yeah, tell us a little bit about yourself and what you've done here so far.
So, basically, I started here at Keystone the day everything shut down, March 16th, 2020. It's crazy times. COVID hit. Try and build a new family culture because I'm family first, which builds our championship atmosphere here at Keystone. I think we have great facilities, great trails here. We have the opportunity to host the CSAC Track and Field Championships last spring, and then we're hosting the CSAC Cross Country Championships this upcoming Saturday. So it's been really exciting to put on championship caliber meets and really build up this program. Being in Factoryville, I give the motto of the track and field factory because we expect to be excellent on and off the track in all aspects of life.
Absolutely. And you were talking about how you're going on tomorrow, the next few days, actually, you're going up there to set up the course and all that for the runners. Obviously, we were talking earlier before the show, it's going to be wet, it's going to be muddy, there's going to be the whole nine yards that they're going to have to face. Obviously, for those who aren't involved in cross country, give somebody like a little in-depth into cross country because there's a lot more to it than just running, obviously.
So cross country is my love. That's what I really enjoy. It's more of a family. It's more of a team type atmosphere. You're running for a team title. You're running for your best seven runners, your top five are your scores, your sixth and seventh displays, and then you have the tiebreakers in there. So it's really, you have to be a family to be really good at cross country. And then cross country is not track. You're not just running in circles. You got hills, you got mud, you got ponds, sometimes you have creek crossings, you get woods, you get the whole nine yards in cross country, and it really takes a athlete with a good mental capacity to really succeed in cross country.
Absolutely, and then from the athletics standpoint of it and the whole family standpoint, Karen, I'm going to jump back to you. Obviously, family is huge with this. That's something that's from the top down. Yeah. But even to have a season and to be back with this family, that is huge in of itself. Yes, no?
Yes, absolutely. Since COVID came, the last season we had was canceled my junior year. So it's very refreshing being back in that competitive environment, competing with other people, you know, just running. I just feel as though, like, when I do run against other people, it just pushes me a lot more compared to just running by myself or just with my teammates. You know, always at a meet, there's plenty of other schools, so you're never just running by yourself. You're always running with somebody who's always going to push you, who's always going to just tell you to keep going no matter what. So just being back in that competitive environment, I really enjoy it.
Obviously, as a senior, you're going to be moving on here shortly, graduating and all that.
Yes.
If you had any advice for either freshmen this year or upcoming prospective freshmen that do join next year, what would your advice be passing on to upcoming prospective runners?
If I could give any advice to any upcoming prospective runners is make sure you just run. Just run a lot and don't ever give up. There are going to be a lot of times when you doubt yourself and you want to stop because cross country is a mental and physical sport. More mental than physical, but, you know, if you just got it in your head and you just tell yourself to not give up, just keep going.
Absolutely. And obviously, you guys said you got the championships this week, which is huge. Don't stop, keep going and all that. Coach, with that being said, obviously, when people come in, they could be coming in where they've ran high school in in high school, where they've done it professionally on some other level, whether it's Steamtown Marathon, Boston Marathon, et cetera. What do you tell, whether it's new runners or seasoned runners that are already involved with the program to a certain extent, what do you tell them, like, on a weekly basis when you guys are getting ready?
So, basically, cross-country is an interesting sport. Anybody really can do the sport. And competitive-wise, D3 level, you have, it's basically different divisions within the same division. Like, you got the Hopkins, the MITs, who are powerhouse programs, and then you got the CSAT conference, which is more like a good environment that's more family-type atmosphere where you're just going out for the pure joy, love of the game, so to speak. So that's really what cross-country is all about. It's you do it because you love to run, because not many people love to run, so like you really have to want to really succeed at the sport.
Absolutely. You got to love to run. And AM, for your aspect as a coach, obviously, and Cam touched on earlier, you got to have both mental and physical capabilities to this. What is something that you always see that's like common in athletes where you just like you need, this is something you need to work on, or any tips for the athletes out there?
So the nice thing about cross country and track and field is all time oriented. So we basically know how fast you're going to run in a race based on what we're doing in workouts. And basically, a race is no different than what we're doing in practice. It's the same thing. You just have to keep it simple and really believe that you hit these times in practice, you can hit them in a race.
Absolutely. And hitting times is very key, especially when everything is timed. Obviously, the higher you finish, the lower your score, which is key for you guys, if I remember reading the stats correctly. That said, obviously, coaching aspect as well. JT's not here with us this week. We're going to give a quick shout-out to him. He was supposed to be here. Obviously, he had his dealings there. You can't do it yourself. You have a great staff behind you, whether it's JT Strum, Nicholas Stanton, etc. Tell us what someone like JT brings to your program from the coaching aspect of it.
So, as a coach, especially at a college level, I really enjoy having alums around my program because they've been there, they've done it, they know what it takes to be successful at this level. So, having JT and Coach Strum out there on the track who've been through this program and really have the high goal of bringing Keystone Championship, because it hasn't been done in the history of the program. We've been conference runner-ups the last 12 years, and we're hoping to change that. So, but it's not a one-man show. It takes an army to really put together a championship program. And I'm blessed here. I have a great staff of volunteer assistants, and this year, for the first time in our program's history, we got a great graduate assistant from Paradise. He's coming to us from Pepperdine University, so like it's true paradise. He's coming from Malibu to good old La Plume out here. So
wow.
It's really blessed to have a good staff with a good knowledge of the sport and know what it takes to be successful at the college level.
Absolutely. You got to not only walk the walk, you got to talk the talk, or in this case, you got to run the walk. But yeah, it's glad to have both of you here. Cam, it's your senior meet, so you're on your last year here. So good luck to you.
Thank you.
And good luck to you, Coach, for your rest of your year. A couple two meets here. You have any outlook for us? Are we going to take it home this weekend or no?
So this season has honestly progressed the best of any season I've had in my coaching career. Like, I couldn't have asked for a better environment. The team came together as a family right at the beginning of August, and we set our sights on the prize. From day one, we had the goal of coming home with the championship because, like I said, 12 years in a row conference runner-up, it leaves a sour taste in our mouth, especially for Coach Strum and JT. So we're trying to put it together. And this season, we won the CSAT preview meet. We went through the regular season undefeated against all the conference competition. So the outlook looks good. And if these guys just come out and do what they're capable of, and what we've been doing all year, it's going to be a really fun and really special day. And I have high hopes for Saturday, but on paper, it's really close. It really, honestly, anybody in this conference could win on any given day. But I believe in these guys, and I think we have a good chance.
Obviously, and a best luck to you, both of you, this upcoming meet. Coach, obviously, the meet starts on Saturday. You said it's up at McDade Park, correct?
Yes. Come out and support the Keystone Giants. We're at McDade Park out in Scranton. We're calling it Defend the Mountain because it's definitely a hilly, challenging course, and the elements on Saturday are going to bring a whole new game to the ballpark.
Whole new game, veteran talent, great leadership, both in the student level and the coaching level. Keystone College Cross Country is on top of it, putting one foot in front of the other, making it happen every week. Great season to them. great end of the season as well, upcoming for their final match. Nothing but excitement here. Gentlemen, I'd like to thank both of you for joining us this week on episode 35, Voice of the Giants, and we will see you next week. Signing out.